What's up, friends? Chuck here, and welcome back to Subnautica. Okay, so, since the last episode, I've actually done a fair bit around the base, and I'll show that off right now. First thing we're going to take note of is the semen itself. So I said in the last episode that I was going to make, like, its tougher armor thing, whatever it was called, which I've done. What I've also done is, and why it's over here, is I've made it have that thermal thing to charge the batteries, because at the end of the last episode we were only on like 9%.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
It's here, we're at 100% energy. We were at like 9% energy going down and doing everything. I mean, we could just take spare power cells with us, but if we're going to go down into the depths of the volcano region, it's just going to charge for us, so we may as well, right? So let's have a look. We have the pressure compensator, which we know. We have the jump jets, which we know. This is the thing. Recharge the power cells in hot areas. Doesn't stack. So, yeah, like I said, go down the lava area. This will charge us up, and we should be fine. And then we've made it so that we don't get hurt as much. So I think we have the perfect setup. I don't think you can get better than this to go down into the lava area with the grappling arm as well. And just, yeah, I think we've got the best setup we could possibly have for that. Now, I did reset the game again with the deleting the cache folders and stuff, which has made Mama Worm disappear. So let's just, like, for RP, let's just say that she admitted defeat, that her babbies were gone, and that she just went home. No, let's just go with that, because obviously it resets everything, so now we have all this salvage and stuff around here as well. Which, you know, is a bit annoying, because it's like, it makes it a bit easier to find stuff like quartz and salvage and stuff, but I mean, we would have just found it anyway, so it's not too big of a deal. Now, the big thing I did is, oh yeah, I figured it out. I have made, instead of going double, I thought, fuck it, we'll go like balls to the wall, we'll do like the triple
oxygen.
Oh shit. We'll do the triple aquarium for each type. So that's what I've done. And I put in a window so that it can look outside. And it's also kind of handy for us to, like, while we're going past, we can see which one is which. So that's like crash fish, obviously. And then this one's like the snakes. This is the shark one. This is the rays. And this will be the ball sack dugongs. Now, what I've also noticed is I took away the signs as well from
Welcome
hatches
aboard,
because,
Captain.
I don't know, it wasn't necessary really. But what I've noticed is that if they, I don't know whether it's just because they're in their own aquarium or whether they're just in a larger aquarium, but they're starting to breed and they're starting to make their own eggs, which is great. So I think the rabbit rays, actually, like, there's a fuck ton of them now. And if we go in here, look at all these eggs. Like, I put two or three in, maybe? Probably, yeah, I would say two. And they're just breeding like crazy, which is great, because we're going to fill up with all the sorts of stuff. So what I did was I put the sharks all in here, and I also put this electric eel that we had in here as well, just in case you needed, like, just, like, the solo species in a tank for it to breed. That was in with the crash fish, and considering there's already three species in here, I thought, well, I'll put like all the one-offs in here, and then that way, like, if they don't breed, whatever. But that means that the snakes, look, we had six snakes, we now have, I don't know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 maybe? So they've bred, and you can see here, there's one egg here, there's three eggs, so there's going to be three more of them coming. The crash fish went nuts. Look at him. Look, you can even see a little wee babby one. Look how fucking small it is.
Ah, it's so cute.
So they've been breeding. There's two more. So yeah, pretty awesome. I really like this, and it took a long ass time. So, as we saw last time, you couldn't just build straight underneath. It was red and stuff. What I ended up doing was deleting the sign, deleting the hatch, then deleting the aquarium itself, then I could build underneath. So because the aquarium was built, it wouldn't let me build the second layer. So I got rid of everything, so it was just the multi-purpose room itself, then build another one, then build another one, and then build all the aquariums on top. And this first one here has this ladder that we can go down if we want to get, if I can click it, if we want to get to the second level or the third level for any reason, and the rest don't have a ladder. So if we want to get to the very end bottom level of the dugongs, we have to go all the way through here. I mean, I guess we could make a hatch down there on that very end, but we're going to expand. But yeah, it took a while. So hopefully you enjoy that, because I think it's a lot better. And the fact that we have these windows and they can see out of them and stuff, I'm thinking about also putting a window on this side as well, so you can see from whatever angle you're in. But again, that's all just, you know, extra stuff that's not super important. What is this? Oh, it's salvage, nice. Okay, so I've done this and I've made everything as good as it can be for frames, but we're still sitting at 30 and it's chunking down a little bit. So hopefully that picks up a little bit, but you know, you never know. Let's turn all this salvage into titanium quickly and put it away. Now we do have another message on our message thing, because it keeps beeping at me, but I didn't want to do that off camera, so we'll do that quickly as well. Now, I think at the end of the last episode, I think I said that we were going to go, like, take some artifacts and go to all these, like, the artifact cave thing. Where's all my beacons at? Alien fucked up base. We want to go back there with an artifact. Floating Port City, no. Cave entrance artifact. That's where we want to go. I think we want to check out that cave in its entirety, and then go to cave fucked up base, and also go to, where is it? Lost River cave thingy as well. So I think we'll do them. I don't know how many artifacts, whatever, but we'll take whatever we've got and we'll do it. But what I also wouldn't mind doing is going to all the, dropships that we've already been to, because apparently you can get like the upgrades for your fins and all that stuff and air tanks and shit, and that seems really useful, right? So we can swim faster and we can do all this other stuff faster. Seems like a good thing to do. So we might do that first, which is going a little bit back on what I said, but you know, priorities change and all that shit. We don't probably need this power cell actually. We can put that away. Copper ore we will keep. There's all the signs that I got rid of, because it's one copper wire per sign. So we'll put the quartz away. We'll come back for the artifacts, right? We'll go do all these dropships first. Okay, let's get this message. Okay. That wasn't overly super interesting, actually. So, all the dropships. What do we got? We got dropship 4, or life pod, sorry. 4, 3, 6, 17, 7. That's the origin thing. And life pod 2, which we've already been to this time. So we'll go do all these first. All right, and see if we can get some upgrades. Then we'll do the artifact stuff. Let's... How many artifacts do we have? We have one here, orange. We needed an orange one for somewhere. I think the orange one was cave thingy. Alien fucked up place. Lost River cave thingy. Alien fucked up place was green. I don't think we have a green. In here we've got a few purple ones. Yeah. So you have two purple ones and an orange one, but we don't have any green. So I don't know. I don't know. I don't know how that works. Either way, let's go to these beacon things, right? So let's get rid of that. Let's put on Lifepod 4. Where are you, Lifepod 4? Where are you? Hello? Did I put it on? I didn't put it on. Where the fuck is it? Okay, well, let's go get the chicklet. Because none of these are going to be super deep. And the chicklet can go 900 meters now anyway. So we can when we come home, we can permanently dock the chicklet in here. And effectively just dock the semen at that thermal plant, at the thermal thing, because when I came back, and it was, by the time I got home, it had 4% energy left, and it used the entire energy the base had, full energy, and then it, kept sapping energy for another, like, 10 minutes or something. So I figure, if we have that thermal thing, we can just sit it next to that thermal, geyser thing, and it can just sit there and just regen while we're doing other stuff. I don't know how quick it is, we'll see. I assume, like, when you're down in the depths of the lava joint, where it's, like, super, super fucking hot, that it will just regen your energy while you're still moving around. Otherwise, I guess you could just go down there, find somewhere somewhat safe, and then just stand there. But we'll see. So many things to do still. I mean, we've got through a fair chunk, to be honest. We've got, like, all three of the submersibles, which we've had for a while. And we've explored, like, a heap of shit. We've done the Aurora, we've, gone to most of the biomes, if not all of them. Although there isn't that mountain one I'm not too sure about. I think we've got most of, like I was saying last episode, I think we've got most of the fragments and stuff now. So now it's just, like, basically story stuff, right? Trying to figure out what the hell's going on, try to find that power plant down in the thermal joint, go back to the thermal joint properly. Okay, there's a predator face, and near miss. He's done the big shark jump. Okay, we don't want to get out while he's here. We want to let him catch us. No? We really don't want to get out and him take the chiclet. Can we just, like, I just want him to eat us so we can shock him. And then he'll fuck off. Fuck, dude. Come here! Eat me! Eat that thing! Oh, he tried. He definitely tried. His predator face got in the way, actually. Eat me! Eat my face! Why are you scared of me? What is this? This is weird! All the other times you try to avoid him, and now I want to be eaten. Oh, he does have hands. He's got little babby hands. Eat me! Yeah, now fuck off. Okay, that didn't actually make him fuck off. It just made him annoyed. Alright, we may have to do this really quickly, actually. Where is it? It was up, wasn't it? There it is. Where is he? Okay, he's over there. Now's our time. He's gone through the mountain, because he can do that. Here we go. Swim charge fins. Blueprint unlocked. There we go. Now we can swim charge fins. Sure. New blueprint acquired. Love it. Okay, so we've done that one. Let's charge up our spicy meatball in case he comes back again. That was, what, 7? Or was that 4? No, that was 4. Okay. It's a pity that you can't move these to wherever you want because you get confused. I'm going to write these down because I'm going to forget which ones we've been to. Okay, we've been to 4. Tick that off the list. I guess if we go in order, right? 3, there we go, and then we'll go to 6, then we'll go to 17. No, then we'll go to 7. 4, okay. So, life pod 3. I mean, it might take us a while to get to each one, because, like, there might be one closer than this. But at least that way, if we do them in order, you know, we're not going to get as confused. So we got charge fins. Let's have a quick look at that. I'm pretty sure they are, wirelessly charges your hand tool, held tool, while you swim. It's pretty good, like... just cuts down on battery use, but we've got so many batteries that it's not, you know, I'd prefer to have the faster swimming fins than the ability to charge our shit while we swim, because it just recharges batteries when we get home and take a spare battery. It's not that big of a deal. Okay, this one really wasn't that far away. Okay. Do we get another thing? We have a PDA that we've already probably picked up. Oh no, we haven't. Have we never been here? PDA data. Eh, shit. Is this repairable? No, it's not. Okay, nice. How have we never... We must have just, like, not noticed that we haven't been here before. That's crazy. Okay, let's... Oh, I may as well repair you, actually. Didn't realize you were at 82%. 86%. Whatever it was. No, wait. I was at 86% power. Well, I think it was 82. Matters not. Alright, let's read this. Okay, I've tried everything. It's if this fabricator was working, I'd be watching the sunset from my armchair in my private observatory by now. We need to make one of them, actually. As it is, I can barely manufacture the most basic materials with this thing. Want a battery? Here, have a children's toy. What? Need deep sea diving equipment? Here, have some lab equipment. Hungry? Let me turn that fruit into dust for you. My theory is the situational analysis circuits are fried. Ah, right, I see. I'm going forward with this trial and error. I hit every button on this list. It's going to make something useful eventually. Yeah, it's true. All right, so that's 3 and 4 done. I'm going to write them down anyway, just in case. 3 and 4 done. Get rid of 3. Next in line would be 6. Let's have some water. Actually, we're kind of safe here, right? There's no predator face. It's only reef backs. So let's maybe, like, get some food while we're out. See, when you have your knife out, you're, like, you're fairly slow. So if we have... Ooh, chunky frames. If we have the go faster fin, we can probably, like, do this a little bit easier. Come here. Fucking come here. My god. It's hard to do at 15 frames. Fucking... Kill! Kill the spade fish! How hard is it? Oh! My god, this is embarrassing, but it's not entirely my fault. Oh, they just disappear, and by the time you fucking the frames catch up, they're nowhere. Okay, I definitely got that one. There it is. Okay, 2 of them should do. Dunk and dunk. Done. Nice. And we'll get one for... We'll just pick one up so we can put it down and cook it later. Okay, now we're heading to 6. Have we put 6 on? I think we did. Yeah, we did. 6 is... Fuck, a long way. A long ass way this way. Okay, well, I'll tell you what, if we're writing it down, fuck doing it in order, right? We can just see if anything else is close. 17? 17 close? 17's 1,000 meters that way. 7? Here we go. Okay, let's write down 7. So, if nothing else, at least we got charge fins out of it. Like, it's better than nothing. I'm actually considering a restart, because I don't know why this is so bad. Okay, another PDA, which isn't going to help. A sea glide fragment, which is just titanium, and no other goodies. Okay. 7's done. What else is close? 4 and 3 and 7 have been done. So... We've only got, 6 and 17 to go, which were both, like, fucking ages away. So we may as well just go to whichever one, doesn't really matter. Where were they? Here we go. One radiation still suit. Oh, radiation suit on board. Request assistance. Okay. Hopefully there's something else here. I think the one I would want more than anything else is, the longer lasting air tanks, right? Because then you can just swim for longer. That's pretty good. And then the go faster fins. But if you have the longer air tank, then the go faster fins aren't as important because, like, you can last for longer, so it doesn't matter if you're, like, a little bit slower. Okay, well, we're back to base. So this LifePod 6, this must be the one near the base I was talking about that I couldn't find in my travels. Just around the base, because I had no idea what direction it was, and I didn't, you know, I knew it was close, but obviously it wasn't that close. Okay, I'm going to find anything useful in here, apart from a PDA that we've already got. If it'll let me have a look. And another PDA. And nothing else. So that sucks. Okay. Let's write off 6. So the only one left is 17, right? We've done 4, 3, 7 and 6. And 17, yep. Okay, good. Where is it? So this will be the stillsuit wreck, obviously. But I mean, if there's life on 17, that must mean there's, like, we've only got five signals to life pods. There must be, like, if there's 17 of them, there must just be others around that we have to just find, which we haven't done. I know there's one right next to the Aurora. It was floating, remember? It was on the top of the water and we jumped up on top of it. I thought we had a signal for it, but apparently not. Unless it was in a different locker at home, which could be entirely possible. Okay, let's just check if there's any fragmenty things outside. No, there's not. Okay, and there's not actually a life pod here, which is interesting. Down here. Does this take us to Jelly Shroom? Yes, okay. We don't need to go here. Okay, well, we've done all of those signals then. Let's just write 17 down as well. I guess we can go home, get rid of them. And check the other lockers for any more. And then I might do a restart, because I think we can get better than this. Better frames than this. Oh, look, it's a baby one! I want a reef back fucking egg. I want a bad. Is that an egg there? Oh shit, yeah it is. It's a bone shark? Sand shark.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Thanks. Is that a square fragment? Or is it just my eyes playing tricks on me? Just my eyes playing tricks on me. Piss off. Alright, so, yeah, I'll go back and I'll do some inventory management, look for those other, well, 8 frames at the moment, look for those other signals, and do a game restart, because this is brutal. Sometimes it just, like, restarting it makes it fine, and then other times it doesn't do shit, so I don't know what's wrong with it, but, again, everyone has this problem, so. And now it's fixed itself to 22. Alright, well, I'll be back in, I'll be back. Alright, we're back. Hopefully that fixes it, or makes it a little bit better either way. Turns out we did miss one signal, Life Pod 13. This must be the one next to the Aurora. So, if I'm right, it's like over there somewhere. So let's have a look. No? Oh, well, it might still be the one I'm thinking about. Either way, we'll go check that one out as well. May as well make these charge fins while
Welcome
we're here,
aboard,
right? Because I mean, it's free upgrade, so let's do it. It is fins, which we already have. Apparently, we don't have. Maybe we just need them in a bag. Yes, and a wiring kit. Okay, wiring kit. Wiring kit. What do we need for you? Okay, wiring kit is 2 silver ore. Okay. Oop. Wrong one. 1, 2. Okay, nice. It depends how quickly it does charge things. It might be useful. I don't know. Okay, so let's put these on. They're already on. Okay, so if we have this as 96%, I think it only works if you're actually holding the thing. 97. 98. What else do we have that's 83? Yeah, it's not the best, is it? and it makes that annoying noise. I mean, we may as well use it for now, but it's yeah. Faster, go faster fins is definitely going to be better. Okay, so let's go check out this this last...
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Life pod. It does seem fairly high, so this is definitely the one that I was talking about that's on the surface. See if it's got an upgrade. If it doesn't, well, even if it does, then we'll go back and we'll do all the artifacty things, and we'll go search that that river. That river? Is that the right word? The cave. So turns out restarting the game doesn't appear to have a great effect. Hasn't had a great effect. But what can you do? Oh, I forgot to do this. Maybe that will help. That has helped quite a bit, actually. Up to 40. So, I think they're releasing this game, like, fully releasing it in May, which is not far away. They definitely need to fix this shit before then. Like, otherwise... I don't know. There's been games and stuff, and there is games that come out with issues, like with frame rate issues and whatnot. And like, remember the launch of Batman Arkham Knight? I think it was the PC launch, and it was just like the game was unplayable basically. But they, you know, this game's been in early access for like a long ass time, a few years I think. So you know, they should probably fix it rather than launch with it. Okay, the beacon has disappeared, which is not ideal. Okay, the life pod has disappeared, which is also not ideal. Not too sure about that one. Same thing happened to that other one where it just like it said we were in the right spot. There was nothing there. I don't know. I don't know. Let's turn that off then. Let's put this back on. And, I mean, what can you do? If it's not there, it's not there. Now, this is going to chunk our frames like a son of a bitch going through this mushroom forest. We do need to go through here at some point because we, like I said in the previous episode, we never really fully explored this very well. You know, and there's probably wrecks and shit in here that we just never found. Like, look at this. It's just taking forever. But we have a plan at the moment. So let's stick with the plan. Where is our base? It's over this way. So at least we got the charge fins. That's something, right? At least we got one thing out of it. And if we find more life pods, then that's great. I really, really did want those, oh, speaking of which. Oh, okay. So it had just sunk to the bottom of the ocean. Okay. Oh, and there is an upgrade thing here. Nice. Okay. Come on, air tank. Come on, air tank. Ultra glide fin. Okay, well, it was the other one we wanted. We'll take it.
New blueprint acquired.
Wait. Is this even the same life pod? Yeah, life pod 13, okay. And a PDA, which I'm pretty sure we already have. No, it's not. What the hell?
Integrating new PDA data.
Okay, I tell you what, we're gonna go around the Aurora, because there was definitely one floating. And we've got new PDAs, which means we've never seen this one before. Okay. Life pod systems online. Passenger 07, emissary Jockey Kassar has boarded the life pod. Life pod launch sequence initiated. Life pod detached from Aurora, okay. Onboard microphones recording. My curators, the cherishers and sustainers of the world, give me this day my daily goods and allow me my pleasures as I allow those who seek pleasure from me. Okay. Entering planetary atmosphere. External temperature approaching critical levels. Show me the path in life, truth, and love. In substance, principle, and mind. For mine is the power. I am the one, forever and ever. On and off, and on again. Shit. Exterior hull damage sustained. Life support systems failed. Impact imminent. Life is a game, which the universe plays with itself. I am done pretending to be merely this bundle of flesh. I am ready to play for a different side. Okay, well that guy's awfully high and mighty, isn't he? All right, let's do the old they all circle around the Aurora, see if we can find that floating one. If we can see the Aurora, that is. There it is. We're actually pretty far away from it. So yeah, that can't be this one. I mean, the beacon thing did say that it was like at the top of the ocean. Turns out it wasn't. I kind of think I know where it roughly was as well. Okay, they only fucked up place isn't that far from here. I don't think we can get to it from here though. Like, I don't think there's a cave. I think we need to go down that normal way that we did through the fluoro stalks and all the rest of it. Which is a bit of a shame. You can just like cut through the world, it'd be great. I think it might be on the other side of this. It's gonna be a needle in a haystacky type thing though, because I mean, you can't really see out of the water unless you do that, and I don't particularly want to keep doing that. We also haven't fully explored behind the Aurora, like at the back of it, because there was a predator face, and we didn't have defenses at that point. Now we do have defenses, so we could probably do that while we're here, actually. There's the scannable. It's just going to be the propulsion cannon. Yes. Okay, so Al. Is that just the huge cock? It is. Okay. Fuck, we're not that far from... The base isn't that far from the Aurora. I thought it was way further away. Turns out it's not at all. So... Yeah, let's go over here. If we come across the life pod, awesome. If we don't, then too bad. I want to check behind, on the like ocean floor behind the Aurora, and on the ocean floor in front of it as well. And especially now that we can go 900 meters, we may as well do it while we're here. Okay, we're almost behind it. I think it's actually in front of it is where I want to go, unless this like falls off here. Ow, which it looks like it does actually. Yeah, okay, nice. This is where I want it to be, I think. Piss off. Because this guy guards all of this shit. So there might be something down here that we can get. But I think, like I said, I think we've got majority of the fragments. So might not actually be anything. Like, there's a shitload of salvage. And there's going to be a shitload of these boxes. Nothing in the boxes is going to be that useful. Okay. He's not happy that we're here. But I don't really give a shit. So yeah, this is obviously where it's crash landed, come through here, made this gorge, in the ocean floor, where it's landed, and just left behind all this debris all over the place. Okay, well, we didn't really find anything there, did we? Nothing of importance, at least. No, like, wreckage that we could actually go into either. But an absolute fuck ton of salvage if we ever need it. Alright. That satisfies my curiosity for a little bit at least. Let's go back to base. And do this whole artifact thing. Alright, we've been talking about it for a while, so let's fucking do it. Is this landmass out of the ocean? We're just gonna leave that life pod. I can't be bothered looking for it. If we found it on the way, then cool, but yeah, I can't be bothered. So we'll go in the brawn, in the semen, because it's going to be, oh, we've been in here. Can we get in here? Do you think the prawn suit would be better, or the sea, or the sea moth would be better going in those caves? Like, the sea moth's a lot smaller. I don't know. It's a tough one, actually. It is a lot more maneuverable as well.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
I don't know. I think we might take the the semen instead, actually. Okay, we'll just go drop this back off at home. We got to go get the artifacts anyway. Okay, let's drop have some water. Let's drop this guy and cut him, or just let him swim away, as it turns out. Come here. There we go. And we probably need one more as well. Anything will do. I doubt we'll catch a peeper, but we can try. Oh, we fucking did it. Alright, nice. That's definitely enough. Alright, sweet. Put this away, go get these things, and we're done. And we'll get the artifacts and we'll go.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Alright, let's put this away. Let's get the artifacts, and there was another one in here. We only have three, but we might find more, you never know. Do we want to scan something while we're out? Got a new message? No. We may as well, right? May as well scan something. Let's scan for... Why would you scan for reef backs? Makes no sense. May as well just scan for eggs. Pick them up while we're out there. So the chicklet will just regen its health. Its energy, I should say, when it becomes day, so we don't need to worry about docking it, really. We always could, but it's not a big deal. Alright. Actually, do you have anything in your storage compartment? Because it is quite small now, comparatively. It's not that small, but smaller than it used to be. Okay, let's keep everything on us, because if for whatever reason we die, or the prawn suit dies, everything dies with it. Whereas if we die, we still hold on to everything. Okay, so cave entrance artifact, that's where we're going. Okay, I think maybe making all of these aquariums and stuff has caused the frames to die a lot, because I read that, which makes no sense, but well, to me, I don't really know how, you know, programming and all that works, but that the more you build, the more that the game struggles with. Even like, I can understand it if it has to render the base when you go home, but like, if you're nowhere near it, why would that affect? I'm starting. Why would that affect anything? Like, where we're going is nowhere near the base. Why would it affect the frame rate and everything there? I don't understand that. If you know why that is, let me know, because that's actually interest. I'm interested in why that's the case. And the thing is, we're gonna keep expanding that and making it bigger and bigger. So probably gonna get worse and worse. So I think we'll end this episode when we get to this cave, and next episode we'll be exploring the cave. And apparently that's a solid that we've hit. So I don't think there's anything... What am I stuck on? Ooh, an egg. I don't think there's anything left in the gun area itself that we can do. I'm fairly sure we went through everything. Maybe I'll take another look through there off camera again, just to make sure that we've done everything and haven't missed something. But I'm fairly sure we did everything. Okay, just keeping an eye out for eggs while we're going. Although they're all going to be Stalker or Sand Shark eggs, which is not the most exciting thing. Okay, here's another, a different cave system. Do we want to get stuck in a completely different cave system? Probably not, actually. I mean, this might all just be sandstone. Nope. Yep. May as well grab this silver while we're here, I guess. Sandstone? Nope. Don't want gold. We've got so much fucking gold. Two silver for free. Pretty good. Okay, so it's on the other side of this this rock, because this is where the base is, up on this rock. There it is. I wonder if you could actually, like, jump jet or your way up. Well, we could probably go in this cave. It'll probably link up, right? Let's find out. No, the jets do not do much out of the water, as it turns out. This is all lithium, I think. We're actually, yeah, we're kind of low on lithium, funnily enough. So let's pick up some. It's good for, like, the whole reinforcements and shit. Our salt. I don't think we need diamond, actually. What is this? This is all salt. Okay, let's get back in the prawn. Fuck these little crab things off. Is this going to reach water? Or is this just going to be its own thing? Well, we might find something in here anyway. Oh! Chunky! Okay, the prawn, she doesn't fit. Alright, I think we'll leave it here. So, yeah, when we come back, we'll explore this cave, I guess, unless it links up to the other caves. And we'll just explore everything in and around here. Make sure we get everything, and then we can basically give up on this gun base, and we don't need to come back. So we can, like, check that off our list. But we really need, at least one green artifact to get into that base. The alien fucked up thing. And see what they have in that data thing. Because I really want to know. But at the moment, I don't think we've even seen a green, thing. Unless the colors mean absolutely nothing. But you would think that you would need a green one to get into a green area. Either way, we'll figure that out next time. Alright, well, as always, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed that, and I'll see you next time.